Hello and welcome y'all back to another Warcraft 3 audio commentary. I was chastised during the break. Last game I was supposed to introduce both of the players, but I just wanted to let you know I'm very creepy Dave, and this is October. It's the scariest month of the year, folks. It's gonna be a scary month. Let's go ahead and introduce these players. Now, like I said, I don't know anything about Warcraft, but I do know colors a thing or two. And I can also tell you that this guy, WFZ and Infi, he is playing a teal color, and he is in the upper left part of this map. Now, I don't know what this map is. Maybe Pyramid will know. But this map is, this is definitely a human player. I can tell that much. And then over here on the upper right, we have a red player. His name is WFZ, and he is playing some kind of ghoulish looking race, and he's the red color. So I think that's all I have to say. I did my job correctly this time, I will say, and I'll turn it on over to Pyrby again. Thank you, very creepy Dave. Thank you. That time you did it right. These are the players. WFZ is in fact an undead race, and the map is in fact Twisted Meadows. but a ghoulish race also works. This time, I will say, no, Infi is in fact playing human this time. He was playing orc last time, so that was a bit of a typo on the screen down there, but we got it all worked out, so it's good. Anyway, so this map, let's go ahead and begin by talking about the spawns for a second, because these spawns are pretty much the worst spawns Infi could hope for, and the best spawns that WFZ could hope for, and I'll say he scouted the wrong way. He did. I'll say that without a doubt, because look, this thing is going to get over here, and it's going to be just enough time that blade, look, see, the Death Knight just now pops out, and he still doesn't know for sure, is the human here or up here? And if he's right here, this is the best spawn you can get, because you can come over and almost always have enough time to snipe one of those guys. So he's just assuming that the guy's over there. I take back what I said. If you just make the assumption that this is where they are, if they're not here when you scout, then that actually works okay, because otherwise, you have to run out towards the middle, and you scout from this way down here. And then, you know, you might, if they're here, then, you know, it takes even longer to get to them. So I'll say that this was actually good, because WFZ played that well. So I will shut up. I will say that everything I've ever thought about scouting is wrong on this map. And it's the exact opposite, because it actually works pretty well if you just make an assumption. And that is wonderful. So in case you didn't quite understand what I was just saying there, because I kind of fragmented that, I'm going to correct myself and say it like this now. Scouting to the right of you is the undead on this map. To the right, yeah, to the scouting clockwise, we'll say. So from here to here makes the most sense on this map, because it lets you make the assumption, if they're not here, that they're here. This is the best spawn, so you just run over this way. And when you get here, just a few seconds after your Death Knight starts running out of your base, if it turns out you're wrong, you can just come here. That's not a big deal, because you're not going to do any kind of serious damage no matter what getting to the cross spawn. You can still do some decent damage coming in here, because you can come in as peasants are walking up. So that actually works pretty well. And Infi's going to go for this creep and this expansion, which is a little bit insane, because WFZ is right here. And not only that, he's pumping fiends out. So this could be a damaging expansion. Although I will say, WFZ taking way too much damage on that Death Knight right now. He's got that one fiend. One fiend's not going to really help him if that Death Knight is taking that much damage. That's way, way too much damage to be taken on your Death Knight. But here he comes in. He's going to go for the coil still on this Ogre Magi. He timed it pretty well. He's going to have to get some hits off on it with the fiend. He's now in coil range. He will be able to pick it up and steal the XP. Is he going to go down? He's going to go ahead and TP out. It's kind of expensive. A Ring of Regeneration picked up. Oh, or no, that was Rune Bracers right there, because the Ring of Regeneration came from this shop, I think. I believe. I could be wrong. I don't think this drops Rune of Bracers. I don't even know anymore. It looks like he got the rings from this one and then the rune from over here, but I don't know. It doesn't matter either way. Really, not really. He got two very good items on that Archmage. This one, he'll probably just sell it. But it's good in the early game if your Archmage is taking some damage. And the reason it's good is because a lot of times you'll see Archmage gets focused kind of to force him out of the battle. If he's got that, it's not going to happen. And secondly, Rune Bracers are obviously incredibly important, because it just says, hey, I dare you to nuke my hero. you're doing no damage to me. Because heroes innately have 20 or 30% magic reduction to all spells. So if you coil it, normally does 100 damage, it'll do 70 damage to the Archmage. So if you have the Rune Bracers, that reduces it by another 33%, roughly. I'm not exactly certain how that works. I don't know if it stacks multiplicatively or additively. Probably multiplicatively. Braces drops from the lab. Yeah, that's what I kind of figured. But I just... I was wrong. I will admit I was wrong. anyway, so... Yes, there we go. Slaughterhouse going up. And we're seeing WFZ play for a very aggressive... style here. Staying at tier 2, getting the Slaughterhouse. He's probably going to see this canceled. These fiends in the back are being kind of nice. He's got this extra Acolyte from scouting. Just kind of chilling out. He's going to be able to remake a Slaughterhouse at some point here in just a second. And the Lich is very close to coming out as well. These ghouls have been used in this fight. And the Archmage slash the human player is kind of repelled. He's leaving those water elementals behind. Because why not? You know, melon mentals. The Lich finally coming out. Slaughterhouse has been severely delayed. I will say it makes sense to go ahead and go for that kind of play where you go for the Slaughterhouse and you go for the Lich before you tech in this sort of position, because look, you can be super aggressive, and you can do a sweet, sweet wagon push when the distance between your base and their base is that little. It's crazy. He's nuking him down, but look, he doesn't even care. He does not care. He's got the Ring of Regeneration. He's healing up. He's got the Rune Bracers. He took like no damage. Boom. Coming back in for the Slaughterhouse. But on the flip side, I will say going for the tech, not really the bad choice either, just because this Archmage is playing way too greedy as well. He's even going to be forced to TP. He does have all these wonderful regen items, but still, if you get caught by slowed, you can get blocked and you can be forced out by being killed. But there is something to be said, though, and if I can finish my sentence, brain, let me work. Brain's like, no, I don't think so. If you fast tech and get the Lich and do the fast tech and don't go for the Slaughterhouse, and the only reason that you would ever do that is because of the fact that WFZ had a terrible kind of harass right there. It was terrible. It went really bad for him. He had to TP. And I guess he was able to delay the level 3 a little bit, but not really that much. And so he knew it was coming. He knew that there was going to be an incoming harass from the human player to try to cancel the Slaughterhouse. So if you're teching, that can't be canceled unless they kill all your acolytes. And he had an extra acolyte anyway, so it would have been reasonable if he had gone for the tech, but he didn't need to. And now he can instead go for a really strong push. So nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong at all. And I mean, this is gonna be really powerful because these two towers are not going to live. Not even 2 seconds. Look. Two volleys dead. Yeah, he's going to go ahead and cancel the second tower because he knows there's no chance. But he is creeping out this mercenary camp. He does have a Goblin Zeppelin, and he picked up a Force Troll Berserk. He's got plenty of footmen as well as a Mud Golem coming out. So he's going to be able to do some sort of micro play here and try to kill stuff. Going to see maybe the Arcane Tower going down because it only has 0 levels of masonry upgrade. That means no masonry upgrade at all. And even though everything is repairing it, oh, he could have killed it. But he backed off just slightly too soon because here comes Infi. I'm trying to catch him in a bad spot. And with the Mud Golem, he actually is going to be able to go ahead and catch him in a bad spot. We're not going to see any kind of burrow play. There is a dust preemptively, just because why not? I'm kind of surprised that we didn't see a Frost Nova right there, because he had the mana for it, and that was a bunch of group duff stuff. I guess he just doesn't care that much about that stuff. Oh, he's going to try to kill that. Fiends will never be able to kill that Mud Golem at this point, because as long as it's getting microed like that into the Zeppelin, the Fiend attack will never reach. So he can just keep microing that, as long as he micros it well. Level 3, being picked up now on the Death Knight, the Mud Golem coming down once again just to have some micro play. And we're going to see the statue that's been slowed this time. An Acolyte coming down. He's got the extra one. He wants to go ahead and use that to repair those statues. Keep him alive. Are we going to see any wagons coming out anytime soon? Wagons would be great. Just to have one wagon would be okay. Well, he doesn't really need wagons. To be honest, the wagon push, the idea behind the wagon push is to siege the human base and to basically put him on a clock. But if there's not really any towers up, you don't really need it. However, there are towers on their way up. But again, these are building towers. All he needs to do is focus them down. And they'll die really quickly. The problem is that Infi is saying, well, I'm willing to trade this a little inefficiently, although I'm going to micro my bum off, and you're not going to kill much of anything, because you don't have web. And he could have researched web by now. That Zeppelin has been really incredibly annoying. And here comes some Militia as well. But again, this is kind of putting him in a spot where he's buying time to get those towers up. And again, he's okay with trading an official here. That could be, that's an ample time. Could have killed the Mud Golem if he just switched with these two fiends and that Lich. He could have killed it one volley, but he didn't. That's okay. He switched with the Lich just a little bit at the end of that, but then it got picked up. So there you go. One tower going down. I'm surprised he didn't just go for the tower kills faster. It's like one volley from all of that, and he could have killed every one of those towers and just microed a bit. But you can see he has taken quite a bit of damage. So dealing with the human army was a big threat. It certainly was a big threat that you have to deal with. That Zeppelin is just being incredibly useful. Gonna go for this. Mountain King coming out. He's gonna go ahead and bolt one of these Crypt Fiends. This has two attack upgrades on these Fiends. As long as he keeps his army alive right now, he's just doing a ton of damage. And we're definitely gonna see Spellbreakers being forced out of this. There's absolutely no way that... There's no way Infi can survive without some kind of tier 2 units here. I mean, that's the whole reason you go Spellbreakers, really, for the most part, unless you're going Spellbreaker Griffin, right? Which we're not seeing because it's Archmage first. Mountain King also taking a good bit of focus here. Gonna see a Dark Ritual to deny any XP on that Lich, rather the Lich's Dark Ritual to Fiend. Denying XP, which is a wonderful thing to do, because these heroes are fairly low level right now. And he does actually finally have web, so he went ahead and webbed up the Zeppelin. And here come the Meat Wagons, which makes sense at this point because now he's pretty well thoroughly entrenched in there, and you can kill the shop, you can do all kinds of stuff. Really though, your goal, like we talked about, is just to force the human player to make units. And so yeah, we're gonna see one Fiend going down, level 4, being picked up by the Archmage. He's kind of going in deep because he wants to do something about that Zeppelin here, which is just ever so slightly in the range of those towers, making it really difficult for WFZ to really go in there and pull in like that. He's trying to go for that web. You can actually keep a Zeppelin locked down pretty much the entire time. You can also kind of pull him back with a good web. If he was able to do that, he would have been pretty nice shape. The problem is if you kill the Zeppelin while it's webbed or ensnared or whatever, the units that pop out don't get dazed because they don't technically fall from the sky and hit the ground. So it's not quite as useful as you might think. I think it's a little bit unfair. I think that, you know, it's a little punishing to people who don't have the ground-to-air units, but whatever. Mountain King taking some serious damage. He's going to get coiled down. That may mean that he's going to trade a Fiend for it. Looks like that Fiend's actually going to get away. Swell micro by both players, except for Infi, who just lost his Mountain King. Spellbreaker's now coming out. They've been, you know, we've got a couple on the field. I'm not sure if they might have killed the Fiend. They wouldn't have. They weren't going to. But it might have gotten mismicroed a little bit. And this is the position that a wagon push is trying to force here. But let's look and see. Castle Tech is not really what he wants. This Shredder is in a weird spot. I don't know what he's doing with it. He's going to finally correct that position of the Shredder and do something. Is there tier 3? Ooh, there's no tier 3 on the undead. That could pose a pretty big issue. He's not even teching for tier 3 right now. He's just going so hard on this push. The problem is, again, to kind of recap on what the wagon push entails, what the goal of the wagon push is to force the human to just mass a bunch of units and not tech up. Because if they don't tech up, they have just Spellbreakers for the most part. Spellbreakers are annoying to fight. They have a lot of life, they have a lot of armor, and you can't nuke them down. That makes them annoying. They also drain your mana, which is annoying. But they're not that particularly great. Unless you have like a high level Mountain King and you can just do some crazy focus fire. The problem is that if they're able to pick up tier 3, then they have the ability to have higher level masonry, which makes your siege less efficient. Also, they have the third tier, which is paladin, and also these are kind of weird fights, and they can get knights. Oh my goodness, they can make tanks and just do some crazy harass. And let me tell you something, if you're doing a wagon push, you have the utilities to kill a tank push. Ooh, that paladin. Ooh, I thought it was dead. But that Zeppelin, once again, just going to be able to come out and do some crazy stuff. But the problem is that the tier 3 army from the human player is really good against the army that wagon push entails. I've said entails quite a bit. I like the word. Get it. What? I don't even know what I'm saying. Anyway, the point is that the undead needs to be teching, and he's not teching, which is crazy. I mean, either you have two choices right there. You can either just go ham with this push, or you can tech up and back off. If you tech up and back off, then you're kind of behind. You're kind of at a disadvantage. It's cutting your losses because your wagon push didn't succeed the way that you were hoping it would. But once knights are out, you are on a very strict limit at this point. Knights just destroy Fiend so quickly. We're even going to see that Acolyte being focused down because he's like, I'm sick of you repairing stuff here. Not really having enough Frost Armors either. Frost Armors are pretty much the only way Fiends can ever deal with Knights. They don't really have much of a choice otherwise. If you don't have Frost Armor, then the Knights just destroy things. They attack very fast, so they... You know, I don't know what the real thing is. The problem is that he can't really afford Frost Armor. He's level 3, has level 1 Dark Ritual as well as level 2 Frost Nova. Trying to go for the hero fights here. If you can get high enough level heroes, you can still win, even if your army is kind of lacking compared to the human players. And that's what he's trying to do here with all these Dark Rituals. I think just keep the XP of the human player down, and then hopefully at some point have enough XP over your opponent that you actually are able to just nuke them down. It's a risky strategy, though. Because, again, your opponent has double economy to you, and they have higher tech than you at this point. And there's really nothing stopping him from just going ahead and making a few tanks and sending them into your base, which enforces you back with all your wagons, and it just becomes absolutely a nightmare for the undead to deal with. So it's very risky to do what he's doing. And even still, we're still going to see units dropping, even though he's doing his best to keep everything alive. He's got 3 obsidian statues over here just because he doesn't have enough mana from these guys. 2 is not enough to sustain the army in a long enough fight, so you have to have a 3rd one. But even that, you can see it's not really enough either, because these statues, 120 mana on that one, 45 on that one, 12 on that one. It's just not enough. You have to deal with the fact spellbreakers are also going to be focusing and burning their mana. We're going to see some damage onto the paladin. He probably will get staffed. No, he's going to have a potion passed over to him. Fiend goes down. This fight is looking worse and worse for WFZ by the minute. Mountain King going to get a Holy Light just to make sure he lives. And he did have the Rune Bracers passed over to him. Going to see a nice staff. And, of course, he's brought in the ghouls, or at least a ghoul. And it's just dropped. So this fight, it looks like WFZ has been repelled a little bit here. If he gets repelled, then the game's over, basically. So he needs to, because he's invested so heavily in this at this point, that if it doesn't do a significant amount of damage, he's just in trouble. And if those heroes are about to level up as well here. It's going for the paladin. Could get a staff on it still, maybe, I think. I don't know if he has a staff. Oh, no, but the Death Knight. Oh, the Death Knight's in trouble. Ah, the Death Knight's dead. That was, yeah. I don't even know at that point what... It's one of those things, if your wagon push doesn't do the damage, then you just get so far behind that you don't... There's really nothing you can do. So you gotta be careful when you wagon push. You gotta bring it all, and you gotta bring it fast. If that makes... I don't even know what I'm saying. Look, we're going to go to break, and we'll be back with game number 3 because the score is now 1-1. It's tied up. It's best of 3 for Have Fun All-Stars Cup. So I'll see you in just a couple minutes. That's right.